Hi everyone, welcome to this week's Halton Hills housing update. So the good news is inventory rose a little bit last week and it still feels like we are in a shift, but then there's certain things that make me feel like we're not. So this is a really confusing market right now. So let's take a look at the numbers and dive in a little bit further. In Georgetown this week, we had 17 properties sell, which is in line with what we've been seeing the last few weeks. Of the 17, 13 sold over asking. So still getting quite a bit of bidding wars. And I had a few listings this week and I had tons of showings on some of them, especially the ones under $1 million. And so it's still very busy and there's still tons of buyers, especially in specific price points. So now looking at new inventory in Georgetown this week, we had 23 new listings. So that is good news because it has been a couple of weeks of inventory going backwards. And it's not that it was like a huge amount, but we did see a lot of new stuff come up. So now looking at Acton, we had 3 properties sell, which is a normal week for Acton. 2 of them sold over asking, so still some demand there. There were 4 new listings in Acton, so nothing crazy happening there, but a good mix of sales and new inventory. Glen Williams had 1 sale and no new listings, and no activity in Limehouse. No sales, no new listings. And in the rural market this week, we had 1 sale and 2 new listings. So the market is definitely still moving. It does feel like we're seeing a bit of a shift. I mean, our sales, considering there is stuff available, our sales are not crazy. I know from this last week, like it seems like some buyers are just like waiting to see what happens, or buyer fatigue is a real thing right now. I just think people are not being as aggressive and as crazy as they were, you know, 4 months ago. So looking at active inventory, we have 76 active listings, which is not a lot, but it is good news because we were seeing inventory drop for like 3-4 weeks straight, which was not ideal because we need more inventory. So to see it climbing back up this week is a nice, maybe a nice indicator, but this has happened before and we've seen it go backwards. So I'm not holding my breath on that inventory is actually climbing. We have 42 active listings in Georgetown. That is up from 36. So not a huge jump, but it is something. I mean, we did push around 60 there. That was an exciting time. But sitting at 42 is still low, but it's nowhere near the lowest that we've seen this year. So now looking at our active price points. Under 700,000 is up from 5 listings last week to 6 this week. Huge jump, I know. Again, not enough in this price point, but it's up, so that's good. 700,000 to 800,000 remains the same at 8 active listings. 800 to a million is up slightly. We saw quite a bit of properties enter that market in that price point last week, especially in the Delrex area. So last week we were at 7 active listings. This week we are sitting at 10. And good news for the million plus buyer. So we had 13 last week. We are at 18 this week. So that is the price point that saw the biggest jump. And it's definitely where we needed it. That started to really get scarce there. So there is some pretty decent properties, especially in Georgetown South, available in that price point right now. So in Acton this week, we are up from 8 active listings to 9 active listings. So we're not seeing any huge jumps here, but we're not going backwards. So again, that is a win. In Glen Williams this week, we are down to 4 active listings from 5. 4, like 2 to 4 is a norm for the Glen. So that's good. But the bad news is it starts at basically almost $1.9 million. So nothing in that lower ticket price point available in the Glen right now. Limehouse remains the same at 1 active listing, and the rural market is back into the 20s. From 19, we are at 20 active listings. Again, we are starting at 1.2 in the rural market. We have seen very little lower price points coming up in the rural market, but I mean, 1.2 is better than the 1.9 in the Glen. We've talked about in the previous weeks that our rural market tends to spike in sales when our million plus is dipping. And so I think we might settle for a bit because our million plus is increasing. I'm finding it really hard to predict anything. There's signs that things are majorly changing, but then you get a listing that has 20, 30 showings. You're seeing still some properties getting 7 to 10 offers. And it's like, okay, is it changing? I'm finding it very product specific. And so I just don't know anymore. Like, I feel so dumb sometimes because I want to be able to predict what's gonna happen. I watch these numbers so closely, and every week I just don't know where it's gonna go. This week's saving grace is that we have an increase in inventory, so yay to that. But we were there and then we saw inventory drop by like 30 units in a matter of like 2 weeks. So I don't know what's gonna happen here. But if the change we're feeling is actually going to impact the whole market, I imagine July will be when we start to see it shift. People are getting a little back to normal. So I'm watching this closely, but I honestly am feeling feeling as confused as the general public because there's no rhyme or reason to what anything is getting, how many showings a property can get. It's just really confusing right now. So we're kind of an in-between. There is signs of a change, but then signs that there isn't a change. So I don't know. We'll keep watching. Next week, I'm gonna have June's numbers. Those are gonna be interesting. And we'll see, hopefully next week, our inventory continues to rise and we are back on this trend of having some options for buyers. So I will be back next Tuesday. I hope you all have a great week. See you then.